Let's tackle perhaps the biggest misconception of all. Socialism has never worked. This one comes up in every single conversation about capitalism. Whether you're
Vuvuzela, brother! Vuvuzela attack helicopter. Pinochet did nothing wrong. 100%. Ooh, I got him. Oh my God. Here, look at me. I'm throwing up the okay signs. Are you triggered? Are you triggered, libtard? Hell yeah! Socialism. Vuvuzela 100.
Advocating for socialism or not? It's a knee-jerk bit of propaganda that most Americans have swallowed hook, line, and sinker. First, we need to realize that socialism, like any system, is a spectrum. You can implement socialist policies in capitalist countries, and vice versa. To say socialism has never worked is just as silly as saying capitalism has never worked. But let's look at a few specifics. We'll start with Bolivia. If you're an American, the most you've probably heard about Bolivia is that their former leader Evo Morales was some kind of horrible dictator. This is anti-left propaganda. Morales served as Bolivia's 65th president.
Look at how brown he is! The more indigenous you are, the more socialist you are, the more socialism you're doing. Everybody knows this. That's why BLM is a Marxist institution. What the f*** is this man's name? Evo? Why isn't it something good like Hank?
And its first indigenous president from 2006 to 2013. He was democratically elected and well-loved by the general population. He is not well-loved by the United States. Why? Because he's a socialist, and he tried to free Bolivia from US influence and the control of multinational corporations. During his terms, Morales worked to improve the lives of Bolivia's poor, more equally distribute national gas profits, and introduce programs to combat illiteracy, poverty, racism, and sexism. These strong socialist policies led to a period of notable economic growth, as well as a reduction in poverty. Morales is regarded by many, with the exception of the US, as a champion of democratic reforms, common sense policy, anti-imperialism, environmentalism, and genuine care for the poor and working families. He objectively improved the lives of his people. To the US, he's a big scary dictator. Then there's Burkina Faso under the leadership of Thomas Sankara. Sankara assumed office at 33, having led a popular movement to overthrow the dominance of French colonial power. As a Marxist revolutionary, Sankara was deeply concerned with the health and well-being of the people of Burkina Faso. Immediately upon taking office, he launched a massive campaign to feed, house, and provide medical care for the entire population. He followed this with a large-scale vaccination program to eliminate polio, meningitis, and measles, vaccinating 2.5 million.
Classic leftist libtard, brother. Thomas Sankara, he was vaccinating everybody. I heard it!
...million people in a single week, earning the praise of the World Health Organization. As far as foreign policy was concerned, the Sankara administration...
He was microchipping them!
...was staunchly anti-imperialist, and focused on agrarian reform to prevent famine instead of relying on foreign aid. They prioritized strong education, and planted over 10 million trees to stop desertification in environmentally threatened areas. Sankara appointed women to high government positions and encouraged them to work outside the home in an attempt to reform outdated patriarchal notions. He also had the integrity to lead by example, only accepting a military officer's salary, and redirecting the presidential salary to an orphan fund. Thomas Sankara's socialist policies did more to improve the lives
of- Wow, it's a lot like Donald Trump. He doesn't take a single dime either. I gotta stop. Okay, sorry.
...his people in a few short years than most nations do in 100. Poverty was reduced. Hunger and famine were reduced. Preventable diseases were essentially eliminated. Education and literacy rates went through the roof. Environmental concerns were addressed, and imperialism's hold on the nation was diminished. What did Sankara get for his efforts? He was overthrown and murdered by French colonial sympathizers. There are so many examples of socialist policies being implemented with great success around the world, and for each of them, the story ends the same way. A coup, an assassination, a fabricated war, or American intervention. When people say socialism has never worked, what they should really say is capitalist powers have never allowed socialism to continue working. These socialist policies do work. They are incredibly popular with the general population of-
I mean, again, one of the greatest examples is higher degrees of socialization has worked incredibly successfully in areas where there is no American imperialism. And when they are regarded as like European allies, for example, you get to freely implement whatever level or degree of socialization that you want to implement when you are not beholden to colonial powers that want to extract your natural resources. Then you get to nationalize your extraction industry and you don't get 9/11 like Chile did, or you don't get what happened to Iran does not happen to Norway. What happened to Venezuela does not happen to Norway again.
Each country in which they're implemented. and they always produce outcomes that put wealthy capitalist nations to shame. Until, of course, we come in and destroy everything they've worked so hard to build. Why do we do it? Because the United States can't stand the thought of people getting a glimpse of what life could be like under a more progressive, humane, and common sense system.
No, that's not the reason. No, that's not the reason at all. It's because it's natural resource extraction and being the hegemonic global superpower. It's just money. Read some Lenin, lib, I say to second thought. Imperialism is a necessity under capitalism. You have to.
System. So
he's going to conspiracy theorists with that take? It's not. It's literally, I mean, there is a fear of a good example, certainly, but the main reason is because the fear of a good example is less that and more Russian influence or the USSR influence overall, the influence of socialism. But the bigger reason is also just exploitation and extraction of natural resources.